At the southwestern edge of New Zealand, open ocean with Antarctic chill meets high mountain peaks. This rugged terrain can cause localized storm cells, and temperatures can drop 20 degrees in a matter of minutes. Joe and Matt will have to prepare for all possibilities.
Check this out. Look at this game trail. They've been hauling butt through here. That is some fresh scat. This is within 24 hours for sure. Another, look at this, real fresh track. These guys are right smack dab in the middle of prime hunting territory.
Last night, our shelter, everything was a bit wet. We were warm, but we're a little bit on the soggy side, and temperatures today seem like they're dropping. Most of the coals are dead, and as I stir them up, I'm still not seeing any sign of life.
Wind's kicking up.
It actually feels like a cold front might be coming in.
Starting to smoke a little now.
And I see just a couple coals that are glowing red. It's either make the fire now or never.
Oh, I see smoke. Nice.
Oh, very nice.
Nice. Good job, dude. Yet again, Matt pulled another rabbit out of his hat and got a fire for us. That is huge for this environment. Matt, when I was collecting this wood, I saw more deer track and deer scat than I've probably ever seen anywhere. Trails crisscrossing in every direction.
Nice, just right back here.
Yeah, right now, Matt and I've got three of the big four. We've got shelter, we've got water, and we've got fire. What we don't have is food. We've got a hunting rifle, and we've got one round. So I think that we should put it to good use. You don't need to be a rocket scientist to figure out Joe Tedeye's got a rifle and a round to go with it. I'm going hunting.
Think you can get an animal with that one bullet?
Oh, well, dude, it's not even a question if I can. The question is, depends on what it's zeroed at.
Zeroing a rifle refers to calibrating the crosshairs of the scope to match a bullet's anticipated point of impact. Commonly, shooters will fire several rounds into a target and make adjustments to the scope accordingly. With only one bullet, Joe does not have that option.
So let's say if we can get up to 50 yards, how off could that scope be?
There's open areas here, and it's also very thick. So if I were a hunter and I owned that gun and that caliber with that scope, I would have probably zeroed it in at 100 meters. But if we could get within 50 yards of a deer, we'd have a pretty good chance of bagging it. But dude, getting 50 yards to a deer here is not gonna be easy. Matt and I have to figure out how we're going to hunt. We've got one round and we cannot afford to blow it.
Got an idea that we can get pretty close. If it is one of these red stags out here, I can call it in.
You can call it in.
Right now, we're actually in the rut. It's mating season.
Right.
So if I can imitate the call of another red stag, it's gonna feel threatened, like I'm encroaching its territory for
right.
Picking up a lady.
Our plan needs to be foolproof. We've got to maximize this particular firearm and one round that we have. We blow it, that's it. All we have is a $900 hammer. If you can get us within 100 meters, done deal.
I think we could maybe even get up to 50.
Even better. Let me get near that fire for a minute, man.
Yeah, come warm up. It's been a wet night.
Facing a potentially long-term survival situation, Joe and Matt set off to hunt a red deer that could provide meat to feed them for several weeks. But with an unfamiliar rifle and only one bullet, the odds are stacked against them.
Most of my hunting experience has been in tree stands. I've never called deer.
I'm trying to call in these red stag, and Joe seems a little skeptical that this is actually gonna work.
It kind of sounds like it, but it kind of sounds like the noise a goat would make if you punched it in the face.
The roar hunt coincides with the rutting season, when male red deer vocalize to attract potential mates and establish a claim over territory.
I couldn't believe it. I was actually shocked that one of these things called back. I'm in the woods with Dr. Doolittle.
Dude, I can't believe that worked. I can't tell if it's up this gully or if it's on top of that ridge line, but it's close.
It's really close.
Oh, yeah.
this. I'm gonna go up this game trail and I'm gonna loop back around and try to get on this flank. And you just keep calling like a little diversion and I'll see if I can get a shot. Okay.
This is teamwork. This is what it's all about, working together to a common goal. It's beautiful. Poetry in motion.
In this land here in New Zealand, there's not a lot of small game. He's got to be able to get that red stag, or else we're not going to have meat to get the energy to be able to hike out of here.
I'm trying to find a place where I can set up for a shot, and this place is really tough. There's a lot of trees growing and a lot of vines, so what I'm looking for is an open area where there's maybe some brush that I can hide behind, and I find a really good spot. All of a sudden, I hear some movement, and sure enough, a stag comes rolling on by, but I could not get a shot. It's killing me right now that I could not squeeze off a round, but for someone in my situation, you've got to be patient, and you've got to take a kill shot. The sad fact is that might have been my only chance. This is kind of like being in the Super Bowl. You're on the 1 yard line with 1 second to go. You either get a touchdown or you're hosed. It's walking right in front of trees, and I can't get a shot except for about a 2 foot window. And sure enough, Matt calls it right at that time. It turns around and takes 2 steps back.
It's down. Oh, that was a good shot.
There he is right there. That's a bust your ass shot right there, right through the shoulder blade, heart shot. Really, really excited, great hunt. Up to this point, Matt and I have only eaten some very small berries, so bagging this animal for someone in this situation, that's 500 calories per pound.
Hey.
Hey. Look what I found.
Nice, nice shot.
Right through the heart, shoulder. That's a bust your ass shot through and through.
Joe just dropped a 200-pound stag on the ground. I'm pretty impressed. Our next challenge is gonna be able to get that back to camp.
So what do you think? You wanna process this thing here? What's your plan?
Yeah, it's a little ways to drag it back to camp, so let's go ahead and at least get the guts out for starters.
Okay, sounds good.
This stag weighs a couple hundred pounds. Once we get the guts out, you know, we're gonna drop that weight down to about 120 pounds. We wanna get every bit of that animal that we can back to camp, so that if this turns into a long-term survival situation, we have those resources to use and come back to.
Matt, how do you like your steaks, bro?
Rare is great, yeah, medium rare.
Okay. As soon as Matt and I process this deer, I wanted to get some meat on the barbie. We need some food right now to get the protein back into our bodies and the energy that we've lost over the last 2 days. Oh yeah, this is done, bro.
That was a pretty full day today.
You ain't lying, man.
Good job on the hunt.
This is
really amazing to have all this meat here. At this point, our camp's pretty dialed in. You know, it's starting to feel a little bit relaxed.
This is a far cry from where we spent last night, that's for sure. I think to leave here would be pretty crazy.
Joe Teddy is starting to feel a little at home here.
Yeah, for a while. Not too long, man.
A hunter's camp like this is gonna open up a lot of possibilities for someone in this situation. So we have got to use this resource the best we possibly can. So we're gonna shelter for the night, recharge our batteries, and
signal for rescue.
Why don't we eat, hydrate, and just call it a day, dude.
Yeah,